My fellow Americans, we're passing through a time of testing. But in the midst of this global pandemic, just as our nation had begun to recover, we've seen violence and chaos in the streets of our major cities. President Trump and I will always support the right of Americans to peaceful protest. But rioting and looting is not peaceful protest. Tearing down statues is not free speech. And those who do so will be prosecuted to the fullest extent of the law. Last week, Joe Biden didn't say one word about the violence and chaos engulfing cities across this country. So let me be clear. The violence must stop, whether in Minneapolis, Portland, or Kenosha. Too many heroes have died defending our freedom to see Americans strike each other down. We will have law and order on the streets of this country for every American of every race and creed and color. President Trump and I know that the men and women that put on the uniform of law enforcement are the best of us. Every day, when they walk out that door, they consider our lives more important than their own. People like Dave Patrick Underwood, an officer in the Department of Homeland Security's Federal Protective Service, who was shot and killed during the riots in Oakland, California. Dave's heroism is emblematic of the heroes that serve in blue every day. And we're privileged tonight to be joined by his sister, Angela. Angela, we say to you, we grieve with your family. And America will never forget or fail to honor Officer Dave Patrick Underwood. The American people know we don't have to choose between supporting law enforcement and standing with our African American neighbors to improve the quality of their lives, education, jobs, and safety. And from the first days of this administration, we've done both. And we will keep supporting law enforcement and keep supporting our African American and minority communities across this land for four more years.
Speaking of whitewashing, as I believe the vice president did to a large degree about their record when it comes to the coronavirus pandemic, again, the U.S. with less than 5% of the world's population has more than 20% of the world's deaths, according to official numbers. Speaking of whitewashing, they talked about the violence in the streets, including in Kenosha, Vice President Pence did. There was no specific mention of the fact that the 17-year-old who has been accused of murdering two, we believe they were protesters, is, according to his social media accounts, a Trump supporter. Now, again, that does not mean that President Trump is responsible at all for that violence, but the way that the vice president portrayed it, the violence was out of control, liberals, leftists, progressives, and Vice President Biden, Joe Biden, isn't going to do anything about it. He said that Biden didn't say one word about the violence and chaos engulfing cities across the country, although he added last week, because earlier today, Joe Biden did condemn the violence. But no mention at all about the apparently far-right individual in Kenosha who murdered two people. And on that note, I should also add that the Department of Homeland Security Federal Protective Service officer David Patrick Underwood, who was killed and his widow was in the audience, the Vice President Pence referred to him as having been killed during the riots in Oakland. No mention of the fact that the person that killed that officer so tragically, an Air Force staff sergeant, is a member of this loosely affiliated far-right groups, Dana, called the Boogaloo Boys, not a leftist, not a liberal, not a member of Black Lives Matter. And you would think, oh, here's the widow of somebody, a police officer that was killed by a liberal, by a Black Lives Matter activist. No, not at all. Probably a far-right activist.
Yeah, I mean, this is very unwelcome news for a party and a campaign that has spent the last three nights, and likely we're going to hear it tomorrow, with a very clear law and order message, meaning it is the Republicans who are going to keep you safe, and it is the Democrats who are not. Obviously, as you mentioned, that was a really important point that Mike Pence was trying to make tonight. And it is undermined by the reality of what we allegedly appear to have seen last night in Kenosha, where it isn't necessarily the left. And then one other thing I thought was interesting, Abby, was they continue to paint Joe Biden in a very clear way, very direct way, as a tool of the left. In fact, the vice president said Joe Biden would be nothing more than a Trojan horse for the radical left, where the Biden campaign spent last week talking about Joe Biden as a moderate, somebody who brings in Republicans.
The Trojan horse language is, you know, we have to kind of highlight what that really means. It's just that it seems that they don't think that Joe Biden can be credibly accused of having these beliefs. So they are saying that he's being filled with them. He's an empty vessel being filled with them by the far left. I that's very telling about where this party thinks they are and what they think they can convince voters of. You know, I do think, though, that in this message of, as Vice President Mike Pence said, you won't be safe in Joe Biden's America. A couple of lines earlier, he was talking about how reportedly, according to him, unsafe America's cities are in Donald Trump's America. Right. This is Donald Trump's America that people are living in. And it's hard to see how Americans are supposed, what they're supposed to take away from that. They either believe that America is unsafe and on the path to destruction under Trump, or they don't. If they don't believe that, you know, then that might actually bolster their argument that President Trump has this all under control. It's very confusing for people. I think it's really hard to square, Wolf.